This video will cover how and where to get Zotero, and a few one-time setup steps that you can take to optimize Zotero for use at the University of Missouri. To get Zotero, direct your browser to zotero.org and go to the big red Download Now button. This will not automatically start a download, but will bring you to this page, where you will first download Zotero itself, and then Zotero connectors for any browsers you use to do research. Zotero automatically detects your computer's operating system and the browser you're using, so your screen may look slightly different. Hit the blue download button and follow the on-screen prompts to install the program. Once Zotero is installed, return to Zotero's download page and install connectors for as many of the compatible browsers as you use for research. Compatible browsers at this time are Firefox, Chrome, Safari, and Opera. At the time this video was created, we've found that the Firefox connector works the best and the most consistently. If you do a lot of research using your phone or tablet, go ahead and install the bookmarklet on your mobile devices too, so you can add items you find on them to your Zotero later. Because Zotero is a free, open source product, people are always creating plugins for it. These are beyond the scope of this tutorial series, but you're welcome to experiment. Once everything is installed, there are a few one-time steps you can take to optimize Zotero for use at MU. Open Zotero and then find the main menu and choose Preferences. You'll be doing a few things in different sections of the Preferences. You can leave most things in the General tab alone, unless you'd like to make the text size larger. The Sync tab is where you'll enter your Zotero.org account information if you choose to set up a free account online later for mobility across different computers. But for now, we'll skip that. The Search and Export tab defaults should be fine, so we'll skip over those as well. We will look at the Site tab. Notice there are two sub-tabs within this section, Styles and Word Processors. The Styles tab is where you can add some of the less common, more subject-specific, or even journal-specific styles. For example, if you are a sociologist, you'll want to import the American Sociological Association style. You can add more styles at any time. Under Word Processors, you'll want to make sure the Word Processor add-in for your word processing program is installed. Finally, there are a couple of things to look at in the Advanced tab. This section, too, contains several sub-tabs. Under General, you should add MU's Open URL Resolver so that Zotero's library lookup function will work smoothly. Find the Open URL section and replace the URL in the Resolver box with this one. Most of the other sub-tabs can be left alone. But if you use Zotero as an RSS feed reader, a new feature with Zotero 5.0, the Advanced tab is where you can set your preferences for displaying your RSS feeds. Most of these things and preferences are things you can set up once and forget about, or things that won't change very often. The next setup steps will be in Zotero's filing system of collections and subcollections.